All right, here we go. Checking on some Vegas sports history. It's NCAA tournament time, 2021, so March 2021. As I'm putting this together, talking a little bit about the Rebels and their history with the NCAA tournament, okay? Went to four Final Fours the Rebels have. I'm going to talk about the 87 Final Four here. In New Orleans, Rebels against Indiana. Great game. 97-93, I believe, was the final score. Rebels lost by four. Remember that. In the Final Four against Indiana, Bobby Knight against Jerry Tarkanian, classic matchup. But let's go back during that NCAA tournament year. I remember being in Salt Lake City for the first two games, second round of the NCAA tournament, and I remember hearing it was at a piano bar at a hotel in Salt Lake, and I hear the piano being played. Great, nice song at the piano. Didn't recognize the song, but sounded like a great tune on the piano. Go over there, and it's Armin Gilliam playing the piano. I had no idea that the late, great Armin Gilliam, the hammer, could also hammer on the piano keys. But he wasn't hammering. He was playing a nice song. But it was an interesting contrast for a guy who was so tough and strong on the court to be playing this nice song on the piano. So I remember grabbing the photographer, Rick Lake. Rick, come over here. We've got to shoot some video and get this. And Armin stopped playing. He said, no. He said he didn't want me to shoot a story with him playing the piano. So I respected that and didn't do it, but I found that sort of interesting. So the Rebels go on to the Final Four. Oh, before they got to the Final Four, the game at Iowa stands out as most remarkable, where the Rebels won by 3 at Iowa. They were down by 19 at halftime, down by more than 20 in the second half, and ended up coming back. Think about that. Think about what I just said right there, how far down they were. That was in Seattle. I wasn't at those games. I'm in an edit booth in Vegas watching the game, recording the game, getting ready to do the sportscast. Steve Jackson, who's our weekend sports guy, was up there covering it, and I'm thinking at halftime, it's done. No Final Four this year, no trip to New Orleans, just not happening. And Gerald Patio went nuts in the second half, and the Rebels ended up winning the game. I remember Mel Bennett doing the high step off the basketball court. If you saw the video, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But the Rebels were able to come from way behind to beat Iowa in the Elite Eight of the NCAA tournament in Seattle to then earn the right to go to New Orleans in 87. So March 1987, Rebels in New Orleans. And I guess now we're looking at 34 years ago that this was? Yeah, something like that. So the Rebels taking on Indiana. It was my first time to New Orleans, so it was fascinating to be there in the Crescent City and hanging out there and enjoying. They are the Crescent City, aren't they? Okay. Yes. New Orleans. It was fun. I did all the regular voodoo stories. I did all the crawdad stories, crawfish. We did a crawfish bake with Gary Graham and Armin Gilliam. I think you could see it on YouTube if you go. There's a lot of videos of my stories with the team that you could check out. But it was fun being there. I remember Tark had no curfew for his guys. He just said he didn't do it. He didn't have a curfew. Indiana was real tight curfew. Tark said he didn't do it all season, so why do it now? I remember it's 1 o'clock in the morning, the day of the game, so it was the morning. And it was that night I remember seeing David Willard down an alleyway, and he was relieving himself and had a hurricane, a large drink in his hand. And so I looked at him, smiled, and said, hey, getting ready for tomorrow, huh? Which it actually was later that day. But anyway, he just smiled, grinned, and it didn't play much anyway, so it wasn't much of a factor. Remember that team had seven seniors, I believe. He wasn't one of them. They had two centers. Richard Robinson and David Willard played center together, and that wasn't much of a factor because you had Armin Gilliam there. Had on that game Mark Wade, on that team, Mark Wade, Gerald Patio, Freddie Banks, Eldridge Hudson off the bench. And let's see. It was the game itself, Steve Alford. It was all Steve Alford. Scored 33 points. 32 points in the game, I believe, but he was hitting shots from all over the place. Double screens, triple screens, hitting shots, and the Rebels had nothing that could stop him. Although Freddie Banks tried. Freddie Banks had 38 points in that game. He was 10 of 19 from three-point range. The guy went nuts. I remember after the game, Freddie, in the press conference, in the group press conference, said something to the effect of, Yeah, I guess I did have a pretty good shooting night. I guess you did. Yes. And 32 points, if I'm remembering right, Armin Gilliam. But nobody else did much. You didn't expect Mark Wade to score a whole lot. He was the assist dude. Gerald Patio did not play well, did not shoot well in that game. That was one of the problems, certainly, with the Rebels. Haven't heard much from Patio since. Now, he was the guy, but he was the guy who got the Rebels to the Final Four. Without Gerald Patio, they would not have been there. So, I'm waking up the neighbors. At least they're dogs. But, boy, it was a fun game. It was disappointing to have the Rebels lose. It was Syracuse also then played Providence from the Big East in the other Final Four. And then it ended up Syracuse against, ended up being Syracuse against Indiana in the championship game. That was a Keith Smart jump shot to win it for Indiana. But it was great to be a part of that and experience that NCAA tournament. The first one I experienced with UNLV down there in New Orleans, and the Rebels didn't come away. Okay, Tark at the end. Oh, I remember talking to Tark and seeing him at a club. The restaurant had a bar in it, and the restaurant, the hotel that we were staying at had a bar in it. And I remember going to him afterwards, and he had this sort of like, I don't know how to describe it other than a sheepish grin on his face, and just sort of shook his head like, well, I tried. We gave it a shot. We did our best. Didn't work. Didn't happen. But it was a fun team to cover. That team went 37-2. Okay? 37-2, that Rebel basketball team. The only other loss was, if memory serves me well, that was the game at Oklahoma. Billy Tubbs coaching Oklahoma, and at the end of the first half, Gary Graham hit a three-pointer from the baseline, and they called it a two, and Tark, there was no replay back then, but Tark, you could hear him with Tubbs and the refs, and he's yelling, look at the video, look at the video, go to the video, and of course they didn't, because they didn't have a rule that they could, so they didn't, and the Rebels ended up losing by 1 point, so is how it went. But anyway, NCAA tournament stuff, March Madness hitting right now, hitting hard, and hope you enjoy these. A little taste of Vegas history, sports history. I'm going to be doing a few of these, and we'll talk more NCAA tournament stuff as March Madness continues. Thanks for watching. That's the way I see it. I'm Ron Futrell.